Hi, we're Flawless from Street Dance 3D.
So we're coming to Cineworld soon, so book your tickets now.
Cineworld has sent us to Move It to interview Flawless, stars of the forthcoming Street Dance 3D movie. Guys, can you tell me what was like making the transition from dance to acting in the film?
Do you know what? It's been a phenomenal experience. I mean, I think the biggest challenge for us was knowing that this film was in 3D. So we was like, oh my God, what are we going to do that's going to make it look effective and how does that work? So then what happened was we did like a test shoot. So we went down to the test shoot and we tried out a few moves and did different tricks and stuff like that and saw what worked and what didn't work really. And it kind of grew from there. So then we knew what could be effective for the cameras and we had to kind of choreograph to get the right feel of the movie. So I think it was a big challenge for us, actually, to be fair.
It was exciting. I mean, it's different when you're dancing, but when you're having to incorporate acting as well, it's even more challenging. Obviously, it's kind of like up our avenue anyway, because some of us, well, the majority of us did performing arts anyway. So it was like, okay, cool. We get to really test our skills now. So, it was a great experience. We'd love to do more of it.
Tell me how you got on with the other actors, dancers, musicians in the film.
With some of the actors and dancers, we fortunately knew some of them, so that kind of worked in our favour anyway. So that I think with the whole bond of the film was everyone was really just cool, and it was just a really good vibe, and everyone knew that okay, we're all in this to make it work. So and we're all representing the dance world as well. So. It was good. It was definitely good. And it's nice energy. Yeah.
It wasn't just our team. It was like a big team. We were all a team to make this work. Even though it's like, there's rivals within the film itself. We're all here to make this big old movie work. You know what I mean? Everybody wants this to be successful. So everyone just, got along. It was an amazing atmosphere to be working in. It was just hype. It was fun. Long hours, but it was just so fun to do.
Yeah. I think hours went by without even us realizing at one point. Yeah. We were just dancing away and we had to do takes after takes. But everyone was so excited about getting the right take and everyone understood what kind of thing we were trying to achieve from it. And it being the first dance movie in the UK. That was a big enough deal as it was, so let alone to have it 3D. So I think that's where everyone's drive kind of, kicked in from there. Yeah.
Which brings to the next question. I mean, when you started out as dancers, did you ever dream that there would be a street dance movie and that you would be the stars of it?
From a young age, obviously, we've all been dancing and stuff. And I remember the US, they came up with some of the first dance movies and stuff. And I actually remember us all being together and Marlon actually saying, can you guys imagine, like, us having our own dance movie? And da-da-da-da. It was something that, obviously, we attained towards. It's something that we wanted to push towards. We had plans, obviously, to maybe just do our own one or something. But we were fortunate enough for this movie to come along and for us to be in it, definitely. But, yeah, I do remember us dreaming that. And it's there, man, dream.
I mean, you talked about the long hours that you had to work whilst filming, but did you prepare any special dance moves for the film? Anything that the fans should look out for?
See, this is the thing. I don't want to actually release anything biased. Just go and see it. It's literally, it's a film for everyone, really. And some of the stuff that we did do for the movie was specifically for the movie. So, you're going to see a lot of new stuff. We worked on new stuff, which was just after Britain's Got Talent tour, right? Yeah. We're happy with it. Directors are happy with it. Everyone else in the film is happy with it. So we just hope that everyone can, be happy with it as well and representing the UK first and foremost. So, yeah.
Let's go see it, really.
Yeah. Go and see it. Get your tickets. I don't know.
perfectionist, and literally every day this is what we do. This is like what we live, eat, sleep. This is like our work and day and night kind of vibe. So we're literally rehearsing every single day and night, and just really perfecting our craft. There's so many big projects to come along this year, and you know, for us to, in order to achieve what Flawless wants to achieve, we like to make sure that we put in the hours, and we don't leave the studio until we know that we've achieved something, even if it's just like a small percentage. We really like to make sure that we accomplish what we want to achieve in rehearsals, in performances. So we're pretty hard on ourselves, but you know, this is why we're flawless, because we strive to be flawless in every single way. So it's hard work, but it's fun. The end product is, you know, it's a result. So.
I hate to get you to make comparisons, but in terms of physical fitness, how do you think you compare to other athletes, say footballers or the Winter Olympics guys?
Okay. Now, a lot of people would kind of like not view dance as the same as, let's say, footballers or athletes in general. The fact is, dancers in their own rights are athletes, because you have to be disciplined, you have to eat a certain way, you have to have a certain regime in terms of your sleep pattern and whatever, in order to maintain your physical fitness. You have to be fit as well in order to do what you're doing. So it may be a case of them having to run around like 90 minutes on a pitch, but there are people that are, you know, for instance, in West End shows, they're dancing for a full-on hour before they get an interval. So it's, you know what I mean? Things like that. It really takes a lot in order for you to have that form of fitness. So for people to even not consider dance in the same category as sport, it's, you know, it's kind of unfair in a certain aspect, you know, because we put in a lot of hours. I mean, we put in some crazy, crazy hours. Yeah, like, for instance, when we was doing BGT tour, whilst everybody was asleep, we were still in the studio, like at past 1 o'clock in the morning, like crazy hours, like literally, you know, I'm not even exaggerating. We were there past 1 o'clock, so you know, there's not. I wouldn't say there's a comparison. It's everything is pretty much the same, really. It's just a different industry. That's all it is.
My other question is, I believe the film includes some ballet dancers. Did you guys learn anything from them during the filming, and did they learn anything from you?
Well, basically, like, I'm a trained ballet dancer, as well as like contemporary jazz, tap and the rest of it. So it was good to see, well, like most of us are like been trained and stuff, but it's good to see the other dancers that were on the job as well. And it was like, we learnt things basically, like, we couldn't, well, most of us have done already, but it was like using the resemblance of what they're doing in the whole movie and stuff, and like in terms of like the performance and stuff, like you seeing ballet dancing in a street dance movie, and then you're seeing like the way how it's done and stuff, and the energy that you can get from it, even though it's ballet. If you know what I mean, like, for example, there's like battle scenes that happens in the battles, and I won't like let out anything, but it's just stuff to see that you would understand, it will make sense, basically. But yeah.
Well, thank you very much, gentlemen. The inspirational Flawless.
Hi, we're Flawless.
Bros.